Namaste. It's Saturday, 23rd, 2015, and I'm walking down to the station. I'm attending a protest today in Lewisham, run by the People's Assembly. I'm gonna go and make some noise and try and get people see sense in relation to these austerity measures, which are ridiculous, because if you look at the debt clock online, it's always rising. So whatever we do to get back some of that money, that clock always rises. It never goes below, it never runs backwards, it always runs forwards. So we're always constantly getting further and further in debt. So to have austerity measures, to, you know, you'd think that it would bring down the debt. It doesn't. The debt keeps increasing and increasing. And in fact, looking at some statistics online this morning, the debt has doubled in the last 5 years compared to the debt figure for the entire time, 11 years of a Labour government. Reason I'm recording here is I'm walking through the industrial estate that's just down the road from where I am, and this is what we have to put up with, this capitalist system that creates environments or ghettos of aggression. If you look at the fence, trees I can't touch, and it's just so exasperating to not be able to breathe within your own world. And yoga, and being that this is a Yogi Police video diary, is about being able to breathe, and you just cannot breathe. This is the houses that they're building here, which I can, most of them are going to be private, I think. I'm not sure, because I'm not in those circles. I'm not working today. Some of the new houses that they're building up there. But yeah, this industrial complex, which we have to live in, it's just not friendly. It's so hard, it's so aggressive. And it can't be sustained. And that's basically the bottom line. You know, we cannot sustain the way that we're living at the moment. And the austerity protest today is a part of that, which has to be addressed. So yeah, that's a kind of little opener for today. I'll do some more recording as the day progresses, see what happens with the energy today and where we go. Some more of the buildings that they're making. So I'll keep a video diary today of events. So namaste, Hare Krishna, and I'll speak to you later. I just thought that while I was on the train, I'll let you know how I'm feeling today, energy-wise. I feel kind of calm, a little bit of tenseness in my stomach. Overall, not too bad. I'm a little bit dehydrated. It's quite overcast today. And also, I thought quite interesting to look at this website, which is called UK Publish ukpublicspending.co.uk. And basically the website shows you budgets and what basically what the government's spending its money on over over the years. I think it goes back to about, it goes back to the 1950s, I believe. But you can check that website out. It shows you a small graph and see that the national debt has been rising consistently, not falling, although according to austerity it should be falling and it's not. This is a really interesting website where you can get facts and figures, and it's called ukpublicspending.co.uk. Just in case you was in any doubt that austerity is making the national debt drop, because it's not. Anyway, namaste, Hare Krishna, and I'll speak to you later. So I'm just walking down to the tower, clock tower, and see how much Lewisham's changed. Some new buildings there, all these roads are up. It's changed a lot. But, I'm going to walk down to the clock tower, show you who's there. And from here, this is the famous Lewisham clock tower, which is built around the turn of the century, I think. this is the protest, and basically about austerity. I'm going to try and get some people talking about protest. So it's basically get the Tories out. It's, Yogi police stuff. So if I get anybody to do any kind of like interviews, I'll come back to you. So it's Yogi police out. Hare Krishna.
Well, see if this guy minds. You want us to mind holding your banner up?
No. Go ahead.
Someone to hold these up. This guy.
Sorry, it's fine.
So, you want to hold these up? You want to get some photos? And not totally dominated by SWP photos. We can have one or two placards, no more.
Can't blame them for turning out.
Come on, let's get a nice picture. Let's get together. Okay, let's get some photos. Let's get some energy.
Go on.
Okay, right.
Against Tories cuts. Against Tories cuts.
No more Tory cuts. No ifs, no buts. No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs, no buts.
No more Tory cuts.
No ifs.
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 I'm definitely away from next Saturday afternoon. I want to ask questions here.
I'm at the People's Assembly protest in Lewisham, which is highlighting austerity, and I'm with Richard. And so I just wondered, what's the protest about today, Richard?
Well, the People's Assembly is a national campaign, as you know, fighting the cuts and trying to bring together all the very many anti-cuts campaigns there are, both locally and across the country, from the bedroom tax, from Save Lewisham Hospital, from all the various brutal cuts going on in local governments and future cuts we see. It's bringing everyone together, and today it's the first time after this dreadful election where we've got now a majority Tory government who promised brutal cuts, and it's probably the most vicious set of cuts and the most vicious government since the Second World War. And so we're bringing together people who are opposed to this, know the economics of this is a lie, the ideology of this is a lie, working people shouldn't be attacked. There isn't a kind of economic crisis they're talking about, and that was anyway caused by bankers, and they are to blame, not poor working people. And this is going to cause an economic crisis to continue and grow. So we're trying to bring together all the people, and we've got new people here, we've got some left groups, we've got someone from the Lewisham Hospital campaign, and new people getting involved to show that there is an alternative, because there is an alternative in terms of ideas, there is an alternative voters. Only one in four voted for this Tory government who is going to enforce these cuts, and we are totally opposed to it, because the effects are going to be horrendous for ordinary people across the country, whether in Lewisham here or other. And you know, you've seen, as usual, another important aspect we're taking account of is the racist scapegoating goes with it. And we've seen what this government's already planning, blaming migrants. And once again, this is all totally upside down. Immigration stimulates the economy. It isn't the cause of the crisis and the pressure on the health service. And a classic example is the health service, where we spend less per head than most rich countries in the Western world, and yet it's a very efficient service, and yet they're saying it's a crisis because they're not funding it. And we have to get that message out to people and make them realise there is an alternative and then fight for that. And we're building basically this demo on the 20th of June. People's Assembly has been going a few years, we've had some big demos, and this is going to be the first mass, starting in the Bank of England and marching to Parliament now. And
it's next Saturday, yeah?
No, it's the 20th of June, actually.
Sorry.
So it's 5 weeks' time or whatever it is.
Yeah, we've been 5 weeks.
Just 4 weeks today, I assume. 4 weeks today.
Yeah. Okay.
So we're trying to mobilise people for that, and it's on Facebook. It's on emails, and it will be getting around. There are a lot of celebrities involved with it, and it's going to be the first speaking out of the masses in this country against this Tory government and what it's planning to do.
How do you feel about setting up one of the first demos after the election? Because I've looked around online, it's been, as we were talking earlier, a few dotted around the country. This is the only notable one, apart from the one up in London, which was more spontaneous after the election. Do you feel that this is the right way forward for activists?
This is one way forward. People are going to be fighting individual campaigns. I mean, we're involved locally with a local college, Lewisham College, which is being put through £7 million of cuts. They're threatening to close campuses. It's going to deny local people education. And there is a thoroughgoing campaign there. A number of us are involved with it, building it. We had a fundraiser this week. So you're fighting for your individual service, individual campaigns, but you also want to bring people together and make the connection and make everyone realise they're part of something much bigger. It's a national movement, and that gets the voice out in the national media. So I think they're all part. It's going to be a many-pronged struggle for the next 5 years and longer, and we're waiting, hoping for some victories. And there have been victories, there have been setbacks for attempts. Lambeth College just last year resisted some cuts in people's terms and conditions. But it's a big struggle, but every struggle counts, and we're all, you know, building the movement and building the education, building confidence. Because it's not going to go away. So I support all these struggles. A national demonstration obviously has an important part to play in that.
Just sort of coming away a little bit from that, I just wonder what your opinion was on the attack on human rights, but also with students and their campuses kind of being selective of their speakers at their campuses. which seems a bit peculiar to me.
Oh, it's awful, it's dreadful. I mean, there's recent revelations. Theresa May wants to set up a unit that monitors all publications and things that are on TV and stuff. And this is all about stifling democracy, stifling opposition, and it's being used against students, it's being used against the Muslim community in general. You know, if you're radical, you are therefore going to become a terrorist, which is a total lie. Not so, and even all the policing experts agree. So this is an attack on democracy, and remember, they're targeting communities which are resistant. The Muslim community, when they were fighting against the bombing of Israel and fighting the cuts and like what was happening in Tower Hamlets in East London, and look what's happened there. They've had their mayor taken out undemocratically. They will try and do that, and that's why we have to oppose it. And I think the student movement's interesting. Just at the time we've elected a Tory government in this country, only, as I said, one in four people voted for it, there is the most radical left-wing leadership of the National Union of Students, which historically hasn't been left-wing, and four of the six top president, vice president posts are now people who are totally opposed to cuts and austerity. So it's not surprising they're targeting freedom of speech, and we obviously have to defend that and oppose all these attempts to take away these rights. Human Rights Act, European Court of Human Rights, they were put in place after the Second World War, after the lessons of Nazism and the Holocaust, and these people are talking about taking it away. It has to be resisted. A number of us are, as I say, are part of the anti-racist movement as well, making the connection, and there is a campaign called Stand Up to Racism, which works very closely with the People's Assembly, and it is going to be looking at a whole series of campaigns around the attacks on human rights, around the attacks on migrant rights, the bombing of boats so people can't escape total poverty and danger to their lives, and that is a very important part of the movement, you know, and I'm glad you raised that.
My final question, is, I'll let you go, is what message would you give to people that haven't demonstrated before but would like to get involved? What ways could you recommend to be more active in protest?
Well, you know, the first step, and a lot of people of your, obviously by definition this is on the internet, and people, if you go on Facebook, if you go on the internet, if you go on the websites, you'll see what's happening and get the ideas. Demonstrations, far from how they're portrayed in the press, and they only portray, they only cover them when there's a little outburst of a few people, they are actually great family affairs, lots of people, diverse people, they're celebratory, a lot of people coming together, and they're always inspiring. But demonstrations are not the only thing. You know, we meet locally, regularly, to plan events like this. We're going to be leafleting other stations. We organise educational events. And there are many ways to get involved, helping make placards if you don't want to be on a demonstration. But, you know, we all learn. We always have one point when we are shy to give out a leaflet. But if you meet the public, there a lot of people are supporting and interested. So there are lots of ways to get involved. Just contact us, contact the People's Assembly, contact your local group. We're in South East London, there's a South London group, there's a North London group. And get involved and you'll meet people who you'll get on with. Very easy, diverse range of people who are just fighting for justice and rights, not after exploiting people off, and want a better place. And we need your help. So if you've got any interest, join up, sign up, and just share it on Facebook and the internet, any means you have.
And when was the next, just remind people for the next
demonstration. The key demonstration is on the 20th of June, Saturday 20th of June, meeting at the Bank of England, and it's marching to Parliament. But there'll be other linked events with it, and watch this space. There'll be good stuff on the internet. You know, there'll be a Twitter campaign, there'll be a Facebook campaign, there'll be already short videos made. Circulate them. They'll invigorate and people, because young people have had enough. They've got no future at the moment, the way things are going, and we need to draw in at that. And all, older people like us who've got some experience can help that and grow that. So see you on the demo.
Okay.
No to Tory cuts. Let's fight austerity.
Okay, thanks, Richard.
Take care.
Namaste. So I'm at the Lewisham protest for People's Assembly, just filming around, trying to raise awareness. You can see some of the people that have given up their time to come out and protest today. I think sometimes small protests are pretty good. There'll be a bigger demonstration. That's the main table. Some of my banners over there. So it's quite well attended, there's about 10 people, but there'll be a bigger demonstration next Saturday, so come to that. happy like big demonstrations, but I think small demonstrations is always good. It's always about raising awareness. It's mad how some people So yeah, I'm a bit rambly because I'm a bit cold and things are going a bit numb. But I think it's pretty good, quite a good turnout. So namaste, Hare Krishna, and I'll speak to you later. We filmed this area before. And this is Dartford, near Dartford Station. Looks like just wasteland now. But there was two beautiful trees. There's one there, that went up there somewhere. And where that stub of the tree is, there is tree roots, well, shoots coming out of the stub, which is really good actually. But that's what's left of the second tree. And basically they cut down two trees just to have that. This is about the land sheriffs. The usual logos on it are British Transport Police, Selector, DNA, Advanced Forensic Marking, whatever that means. What can I say? Trees cut down, two of them, beautiful big trees, probably about a good 100 years old between the two of them. And that's what you're left with. Just wasteland. The only good thing about it is that it is wasteland. We've got lots of so-called wasteland. It's been taken over by wild plants. So it's probably quite a diverse community in there. Or butterflies and bees and different species of plants, that's kind of on a sort of a more upside, or sort of a more positive outcome to the two trees being cut down. And it's just such a real shame. You can see one tree left there, that's it, they didn't cut that down. But they're basically just stored stuff in there for a period of time, and they put all these new fences up. Oh, that was the new fence they put in there. See, it's all overgrown now. And that's capitalism. That's the monetary system for you. If you get in the way, you'll be cut down. So we can carry on going forward. Anyway, namaste, Hare Krishna. I'll speak to you later. Just come from under the bridge where the two trees were cut down. And there's another tree cut down. It's quite difficult to see it through the railings. I'll come back a bit, we'll just kind of see it. But it's just been cut down. It's probably about 100 years old. Don't see it in proportion to my hand. It's quite difficult to see. I'd say it's about 100 years old, maybe possibly more, maybe 200 years, possibly. But yeah, it's just cut down for this monstrosity being built here. It's such a beautiful area because you've got the pond over there, which is beautiful. I won't walk up there today, but yeah, I just want to highlight what the tree means to capitalism and the monetary system. Nothing, you're in the way, so we'll just cut you down. You're not a being whatsoever, so we'll just cut you down. You're in the way. But hey, anyway, namaste, Hare Krishna. So I'm walking back from the protest today. Had a good day. My thoughts on the protest today are positive. I met some really nice, interesting people who are trying to make a difference, and that's the most important thing about the protest, is that you try and make a difference. And as I've always said before, that if you are fed up with banksters, MPs, just basically paying out so much money that you just cannot do it. But it's good to come out and join other people who are in a similar situation to yourself, and to talk to people about changes, even if those changes are not possible. It's good to talk about them and to get people go, yeah, well, that'd be great. I'd love that. I'd love that to happen. It's quite quiet here today. Just hear the hum of the M25. That there is going to be another housing estate. Haven't started building it yet. Used to be like a chemical big pharma factory company type thing to make pharmaceuticals, and that's the gates originally there. So the point is them having the gates up, because you can just walk in now. It used to be on rollers there, which is quite interesting. I can still roll. Nope, that's fixed. Sorry. Jump up here. Oh, make sure I don't have an accident. Yeah, and that's just the view where they're going to be building another housing estate. It's a shame they don't turn it into a park or something that is quite beautiful rather than new houses. But it's just kind of being demolished, sort of down a little bit into the place. Oh, breaking my neck. So, I don't know quite what the rubble thing is. Things ripped out the ground. It's the old exit from the workers to come in. Yeah, it's just a wasteland then. Just rubble, parts of it. I think nature's trying to take back bits of it. Old drain there, covered up. Yeah. It's almost a post-apocalyptic Mad Max. You could film Mad Max here, actually. You know, just imagine cars riding around here from the film, which is quite strange, considering that's come out now. Well, that is over there, an old thing that's dumped. This is what I sort of say about capitalism and the monetary system, is they use areas of land like this for their own purposes of making money. And then this is how they leave it, just wasteland, an old fire extinguisher that's just left there. But yeah, so I'll wander back out. Bits of old brick. It's amazing how there's just nothing left of what was originally here. You can see nature taking back. Actually growing through the rubble. Amazing Mother Nature in all her glory. I just wander back. Obviously, this must have been the car park at some point. But yeah, that's all marked up for housing. And yeah, it's just really interesting topography. What humans live by, what was down there. Wire stuff or something. Quite interesting. But yeah, that's the old gates. So yeah, I'll just make my way out. Just get over these rubble. Oh. So I don't fall and break my neck. So. It's a nice treading there, which would have been originally from the plant. Oh, I've gone to one side actually. I don't know what this. Ouch. Oh, that's sharp. A little bamboo. Not sure what's down there. Might be able to reclaim that at some point. Ouch! Oh, I keep looking at that sharp. Anyway, yeah, that's the topography of the new housing estate that will be built there. Some nice shrubs here as well. They've planted. To make the entrance look very nice. Anyway, Hare Krishna, Yogi Police out. So I've come up to the other entrance. That's always their idea of stopping anybody dumping on the site. Not that they hadn't done that already. Bits of broken. Broken porcelain. It's just a lot of rubbish down there in the outlet. Nothing of interest. I think it was an old toilet. I looked at it. But what I find interesting when I'm doing topography, I see the steps going down. I'm not too sure what that would have been for. Get the hammer out. And then you just got this wonderful grass that's just growing next to it. just randomly there. If you listen, you hear the birds. So it's quite beautiful. That's, you know, amazing grass, the birds, the trees there. Maybe the fence and the posts are not so good. But then you come round, and there's all the rubbish down there. There's a random thing that's dropped here. It's an old whatever that is. Obviously people got into there for some reason to searching around in the area. But yeah, this is all going to be houses here, so it's going to be quite a big housing estate. And I'll just show you in a minute the marshes and the new road they've built through. So that used to be a block for coming through. It's a bit of a drive up there, and you probably come here, and that was down. But you could always walk down here. This is a public right of way. Other private property, all vehicles, including motorcycles, are prohibited except for GSK staff and authorised visitors. This is not a play area. Beware of vehicles and ditches. Lots of fear. Lots of, it's mine, it's mine. Got the allotments there. Beautiful allotments, bit of permaculture. Everyone working there today. They're growing in there. And that's the difference between an allotment or permaculture to that. That's capitalism and that's activism. So I've just arrived at that used to be the end of the path. Well, not the end of the path, because the path continues up there. So you could always walk up there. But this is the new road they put in. They built the road before they built the houses. So it's not used at the moment, and yeah, that's the end of the housing estate. But over here, can't really see it from here, that's where the marshes are there, which are quite well kept. Just see the tops of the marshes, get a better view at the top, take a just see them through the gaps there. It's quite beautiful. Very important for the environment and for the ecology for the local area. So there is, you know, there's good and bad. More bad than good, but some good. This is one of the drainage ditches for the marshes. I think you can, I don't know how to work down there actually. Get down there. All in the river. Good. Yeah. Oh, lots of nets. But yeah, that's let's just jump down there. Oh, no, oh, let me jump. Let's jump. Okay. Can I go down any further? Okay, I don't fall in. If I fall in, Wow. So yeah, I'm on the... That's really nice. So there's a really good look for you. The marshes. At great risk, personal risk, to get the shot for you. I might not be fighting alligators or tigers or fighting through jungle, but I've got down from there to show you this beautiful outlet. And this is drainage. These are the outlets for if there is a flood. That's what marshes are, they're floodplains. That they're, you know, they're water-based. They're surrounded by water, and they have these canals that go around them and through them. I think some are man-made, and some are just natural. I don't see any wildlife here. But all along there is probably... you could have any form of rodent mammal, from rats to maybe ermine, mink possibly. Certainly could survive on the marshes here. It's quite beautiful. Really peaceful. It's not too bad, it's not freezing cold, it is a bit chilly. Nose is running a bit and I'm quite hungry. It's really beautiful. Someone talking over there. Just there he was. Anyway. Hare Krishna. Namaste. That's Yogi Police out. So I'll just do a little bit more filming of the marshes. Just go a little bit higher. So beautiful. Look at that, it's up the back. It's like this little oasis that's surviving in the middle of industrialization, capitalism, the monetary system, the banking system that just devours everything in its path. But on that thought, what I like about people is that they fight back. And where they built this new road, which isn't used at the moment, don't get any cars going up and down it, they put in a new fence here. And you used to be able to walk through here. So I've walked up, obviously, to walk through. And someone... it's a brand new fence, someone has just come along so everybody can carry on walking through, and just taken just the one bit out for people to get walk, to be able to walk through. Now that's what I call activism. Don't know who's done it, but it's made it a lot easier for everybody that walks all the way up there and wants to go to their homes there. you can walk through. And as you can see, I don't know why it's fenced off. And even if you did want to fence it off, you could put a little gate in there for people to walk through. Very nasty. You can't climb over it. You can't even climb over it. It's so unpleasant. And if you did try and, you could do yourself a real mischief on those. You know that. If you fall on that, that'd kill you. That would be unpleasant, wouldn't it? But yeah, that's really cool. So whoever took that out, nice one. Because I could get through now. Because I would have to walk all the way up there and through that housing estate to get to where I want to get to. But now I can go through there. Bit of a squeeze. I've been doing lots of yoga, so I'm not overweight. So hopefully I can fit through. Anyway, namaste, Hare Krishna, and I'll speak to you later.